And, we're in the midst of not only hurricane season, but we're coming up on the 15th anniversary of Hurricane Katrina. And one of the priorities I know from the ground in driving recovery of this city from Broadmoor was that we anchor our civic institutions, our civic structures, our civic facilities, our community with resources so that we, as residents, could protect ourselves in the midst of any disaster that we would find ourselves in or need to seek refuge. And so our NOR facilities throughout the city of New Orleans, they're about community, and they are safe places for our residents. And so what we're doing here today, and I'm joined by my Deputy CAO, Ramsey Green. Thank you so much, Ramsey. And call him the Chief Resiliency Officer as well. Vincent Smith, who is the Director of Capital Projects for the City of New Orleans. Mr. Larry Barabino Jr., who is the Chief Executive Officer of NOR. Thank you so much. And we are in the heart of course, the Treme community, District C, represented by Councilwoman Kristen Palmer. So it doesn't get any better than that, in my opinion, with this team. And I just appreciate the work that we've done collectively. But to get to this point, even 15 years later, continuing to deliver for the residents of our city, I will be, I believe, on Thursday of this week, delivering a State of the City address. And during this vital time, as you know, needing to inform residents of the state of the city and how we are not only responding to the pandemic, but moving through it, and also what will our recovery look like. The number one priority has always been to protect the residents of the city of New Orleans, not only through this pandemic, but again, really an example that is being demonstrated here this morning with what we are doing as it relates to a citywide initiative to install emergency generators throughout every, for the most part, NOR facilities, again, throughout the city of New Orleans. Installation of the automatic transfer switches will allow, again, for us to connect, in the event of an emergency generators to create temporary cooling centers throughout the city during, again, a major disaster, a prolonged power outage, or even temporary shelter. You never know. And we always want to be just ready and prepared for what comes our way. Again, we've demonstrated that we know how to face challenges head on, and we're not going to stop. So we're going to ensure that backup power, again, in the event of there's any loss in our community, that there's a way for this city to respond to the needs of our residents and doing so in real time. So with that.